Try not to look in front. Yeah, there you go. That's where it's all at. Good. Because if you were to stall the airplane, that's the first place you're going to see roll.
Yep.
What we're working on in this video is stall exercises. First with Paul on a 182 checkout, and then again with Serge, a private pilot looking for proficiency. Stall exercises have three main purposes. One is to figure out a good visual reference point to see yaw pitch and roll when you can't see anything over the nose. Two is to reinforce the idea that it's stick forward that breaks the stall and not the application of power. And three, to develop comfort with stalling the wing. This is an introductory maneuver designed to be benign as we work up to more aggressive stall techniques. Oh yeah, the PFD is dark, and that is a marker in my hand. I call it the heads-up display, and I'm not afraid to draw on the window over here where Paul should be looking. Stall exercises are an introductory maneuver meant to be docile, to develop a good visual reference point and confidence. Make sure you do them in a clean configuration to get the nose high and lose the forward reference. Also with a little bit of power, so you have to manage some left turning tendencies. This is a skill building day for Paul and I in his first flight on a 182 transition. Let's pick it up here just after we do our clearing turns.
There you go. You're gonna lose everything over the nose. So start looking at your reference over there and start to measure your horizon now here where it's hitting the good. All right, keep powering back till we hear the stall horn and then bring in some power so we don't stall. There you go, pitch in some power. Nope, just pitch up, bring in some power. I want to hear that noise. Good, more power. Good, right there. Nice, pitch up a little more. Just until we hear the horn. We'll fly with the horn on here for this exercise. Good, are you able to see the horizon here?
Yeah.
Okay, good. So
I'm good with where we are leaning.
Yeah, we're fine on the lean. Yeah, I'll give you one more turn. Just
I lost it. I'm losing some altitude.
Yep, so use some power and climb back up. Try not to look in front.
Yeah,
there you go. That's where it's all at. Good. Because if you were to stall the airplane, that's the first place you're going to see roll.
Yep.
Good. See if we can pitch up a little more just to get the horn on. And if you're not trimmed for it, go ahead and trim so you can relax. Nice. Try to look out your side there. Beautiful. I see that yaw, so you need a little right rudder. Good. That's where you're going to see all that information.
Okay, that's step one, getting Paul to look here, where you can see all the pitch, yaw, and roll information. There is no forward reference at this point.
A little more right rudder. There it is. You see how you stop? You're stopping that left turn. That's perfect. All right, can we just do an exercise here quickly?
Yeah.
Let me take the flight controls.
You have control?
I have the flight controls. Right. Just watch that reference out there. I'm going to do a little stall like we do stall exercises, and I just want you to see I'm looking at my reference, you're looking at your reference. Yep. It's just like a big docile 172.
And this is step two. I'm going to take the flight controls and pull the airplane into a series of docile stalls and have Paul just watch that reference point to learn to trust it. I'm going to turn the lights down so you can see this better.
It's just going to, so you're looking right through there. You can almost tell me before it goes which way it's going to go, if any way at all. And there it is. Good. There's the stall. That's it. And you're flying again. You want to try one of those?
Yeah.
All right. So you've got the flight controls.
Flight controls.
And I didn't touch power. Yep. Just do what I did. Just pull it back gently. Looking at your reference over here, that's where it's all at. Good. Try to level your wings a little bit before we start so you're a little left wing low. There you go. And then pull. Pull till you get the stall. Pull till you get the stall. Pull till you get the stall. A little more. There it is. That's it. That's a big docile 172, right? Good. That's your altitude. But don't worry about it. Whatever. We're just playing around. Make sure you're looking out here at this reference, because if it does do something weird like roll or yaw, that's where you're going to see it. One more. Good. Yep. Beautiful. Just like that, right?
Yep. We're flying again.
Yeah, we're flying again. That's it. Just releasing the pressure off the elevator, and we're flying again. Everything's out there. Okay, now I got the airplane again. You got the rudders. All right, so play with the rudder first of all. let go of it to see the yaw.
Roger.
See if it'll yaw to left, and then stop it. There. See how you're stopping it? I promise if you don't see yaw out there, the airplane's going to break straight ahead.
Okay,
so then just ride along on the yoke one more time. You're going to feel me pull it into a stall. And then when the stall happens, all I'm going to do is release the pressure. Here comes the stall, there's the buffet, and there's the release, and we're flying again. That's it. Can you do one of those for me by yourself? Don't worry about power, you don't even need to touch power. How do you break the stall is by releasing.
Okay.
Good, so pull it into a little bit of a stall. Wait for the tail buffet. There's the... going to come...
Now, I am aware that Serge is using too much aileron here, but I'm going to pick my battles. Today is about developing a good visual reference point and developing comfort with the stall. Later on, we do falling leaf exercises for him to get better with the ailerons, but that's a whole nother video.
Good, no, you got it. There you go, and you're flying again. Notice that power doesn't do anything. What's getting you to fly again is releasing the stick, right?
Yeah.
I know that's not particularly comfortable, but do you see how that if there's no yaw out there, you're going to break straight ahead?
Yeah. Okay, let's do a couple more.
Okay. Go ahead, do a couple more. I'm also not going to let anything funny happen because I'm looking at my reference.
Okay.
So go ahead and don't worry about touching the power. Power won't do anything for you.
Number 2, runway 25 right, clear the option. Looking for traffic follow-up.
Good. And a little bit more, you'll feel the tail shake. Then you'll feel the stall. And then just release the pressure, that's all. A little more. Then go ahead and just pull back, make it happen. You're real close. There it is. Nice. That's it.
All right, that's all for this video. If you're interested in checking out more long format versions of these lessons to kind of see a little bit more about what I do when I'm out there with Paul or Serge or anybody else, please check out my Patreon page at patreon.com/learntfp. Also, a huge thanks to the sponsors of this show for making these videos possible. And also a big thanks to Michael Bazaar for providing original music, which makes editing these videos just that much more fun. And you can find me on Instagram at LearnTFP. I'm Jason Miller, and until next time, be safe, fly your best.